just popped the perk and chill like poking beans. She just popped the perk and say I hurt her knees. She hurting me, Rich Dome Hercules.
Hurting me.
Two cups, Martell Portney.
Two.
Serve a fiend.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with a video about hair. So yeah, basically I'm going to be telling y'all like the top 11 products, but not really the top, just like the products that I use on my hair that makes my hair, you know, grow and stay healthy and look cute, you know. So yeah. So let's get into the video. Oh, and some of these products, they're actually, well, they're healthy for your hair, but just only, like, only one of them are healthy for your hair. And I'm pretty sure most of y'all know the brand, and there's one of them where it's really not a product, but it's a product still. Okay, so let's get into the video. So the first thing that we have is a spray bottle, but it, I don't know if water is a product. I really don't know, but it's in all the products, so I mean, it should be considered a product. So yeah, now I only use water like whenever I just be doing my hair, like if I do a twist out or maybe a wash and go, but your hair should be already wet if you're doing a wash and go. But yeah, but I'm not an expert at hair, but I know what I'm kind of doing. Like, I kind of know what I'm doing, but I don't know all the way, because obviously if I did, my hair would probably be more, a little bit more healthier. I mean, it's not that it's not healthy, it's just that, you know, like, my hair could always be better. Yeah, that's how I should put it. The other product that I use on my hair is this new product that I just now am trying. It's this curl. I don't know if the brand is curls, but I guess it is because it's on all the, it's on all the bottles, and it's this goddess curls thing. Like, yeah, it's not almost gone, but it, I only had it for like maybe a week or two. So yeah, and it smells really good, and it makes your curls look good too. And then to also go along with that brand, I have this cream brulee. I don't know if I say something wrong, like if I pronounce it wrong, it's because I really don't know how to pronounce it, or I just can't speak. Yeah. So yeah, I use this on my hair like for twist outs. That too, I use those two together. I use those for twist outs and wash and goes, but yeah. Well, I only use it on wash and go, and how my hair is now just moisturizing, you know. Like. So the other product is Cantu. Is the coconut curling cream. Okay. I like the product. I just don't like it at certain. I don't know. I like it, but I don't like it at the same time. It's just too liquidy. I don't like liquidy products. Like, this is liquidy, but it's supposed to be liquidy because it's a gel, but Cantu is like super liquidy. Like, I don't know if y'all can see that, but it's like really liquidy. Like, if you pick it up, it's just, like, it's just liquidy, and I don't like liquidy products. Well, I do, but, like, I just don't like the product. But it smells good. It smells really good. And then, also, for Cantu, I have this Define and Shine Custard. Yeah, y'all know what I'm trying to say. Y'all know what I'm trying to say. But, yeah. This is also very liquidy, like, very liquidy. It smells like pineapple to me. It's like, in order to get the product out of this certain product, you gotta, like, scoop it. Like, I don't like that. And it always feels weird on my hand. Like, It got like a slimy texture to it. Like, I don't want to feel that. Okay. And then, let me try the next. Okay. So then I have this Carol's Daughter Black Vanilla 4-in-1 Combing. This right here, it helps you comb your hair. I don't know how, but it just does. Like, and it smells really good. Carol's Daughter, I like their products. Shea Moisture, I like their products too. But I don't think I have, well, I used to use Shea Moisture a lot, but then I stopped using it. But I usually only use their, like, shampoos and conditioners. But, yeah, I really don't care to have shampoo. I mean, not shampoo. What am I talking about? What was I talking about again? Shea Moisture. I really don't care to have their products. But Carol's Daughter, you'll always catch me using this. If I do any hair tutorials or anything, you'll catch me using some Shea Moisture. I really don't use this much, but I mean, I use it if my hair is like really tangled, or like if it's just like, I don't know how to explain it. If it's like when I take out like, not weave, but, well, I don't know if it's weave, but like if I take down box braids or faux locks, anything like that, I'll use this product and with some water, and then like maybe like a moisturizer and some oil. That's what I do to help detangle it, to make it more slippery. Yeah, so my fingers can glide through. So then I have this. Okay, it just looks a hot mess. The container looks a hot mess because it just be like when you touch it, like if you do that, it rubs on your hand. Like, I don't like that, but it's a good product. It's like a very thick product too. And this is also Carol's Daughter. It's their Coil Enchanting Moisture Butter. Yeah. What does it smell like? It got a weird smell to it, but it's like a coconut smell, but at the same time, it's like a Play-Doh smell. I don't know, but I don't like the smell, but I kind of do. And then it's this thing. It's very small, but it comes in bigger bottles or containers, whatever you want to call it. It comes in bigger ones, but my mom just got the small one, I guess. But it smells really good. And I use this on my hair, too. Now, I used to use it on my hair, then I stopped, and now I'm using it again. It just, like, it's the Carol's Daughter. I don't know how to pronounce the top part, but it's a shine thing, yeah. I'm not even gonna try, but you can read that, right? Yeah, you can read that. Screenshot it if you want it. But yeah, it just makes your hair really light. Just like, how should I put it? It makes it look so healthy and shiny and so nice, and it makes your hair smell so good. So when people be walking by, you can like just go like that to them, you know what I mean? So they can smell your hair. And they'd be like, dang, girl, that hair smells good. Like, I know. So, yeah. Next product. The last product is my favorite product, but it's not also at the same time. But, yeah. Then I have this Wild Hair Growth Oil. This just helps your hair, like, I would recommend a lot of people to use this on their edges. Don't take it offensive, but I'm just saying, some of y'all girls just don't have any edges, and it's not okay. I mean, some people, like, they have edges, but their edges are, like, it's not really anything there. So, yeah. I would recommend this if you bald-headed or if you just don't got any edges. So yeah, or you can use this too. This is Jamaican black castor oil. And it's in a big bottle. Well, it's in a big bottle for what it usually comes in. Usually it comes in like a small bottle. Like maybe like, I don't know. Maybe like right, like to here, to here. Maybe that big. So yeah. It don't smell, it smells like, okay, it don't smell good, but it has a scent to it. Yeah. They have multiple ones, like, it's all the same thing, it's just different scents. The tropical one, yeah, that one, it smells weird, this is like a very thick oil, and it helps your hair grow. Even if you're not bald-headed and you just know, you know, you want to keep your edges growing, you might want to use some Jamaican black castor oil. Well, you should be using Jamaican black castor oil because one day you're going to be looking in the mirror and you're going to be doing your edges and you're going to be like, dang, my edges look good. I'm telling you, watch. Just use it. Okay, anyways, then we have the last product, which is Gorilla Snot. I don't know if I said this in the beginning, but it's 11 products. I don't know if I said that, but yeah. This is Gorilla Snot. This is the punk one. I'm pretty sure a lot of people use this one, and as you can tell, it's very, very. It holds very good, and it smells good to me. Like, it holds good and all that, but also at the same time, you need to use water. Whenever you use gel, like Eco Styler gel, which I wouldn't prefer to use anymore because the products that are, well, the chemicals and all the elements that are in it now is just horrible. And I ain't trying to get cancer from using Eco Styler gel. So, yeah. Gorilla Snot. Okay, I ain't gonna lie to y'all. It do got one product that Eco Styler gel has. But at the same time, if you didn't know, the first three, like, ingredients y'all see on the back of y'all products are the most used ones. So, like, the other ones are just, like, you know, they might use it here and there, like, in the product. But the first three ones is the one that they be using the most in that product. Gorilla Snot. The product that I'm talking about, I do not know how to pronounce it, but it's, wait, where did it go? Okay, yeah. It's like the 10th product, like the 10th ingredient, I mean. So, if you use Gorilla Snot, you should be fine, because I used to use Eco Styler Gel too, and like, don't get me wrong, Eco Styler Gel, it will do you the job that you want. But at the same time, Gorilla Snot can do the same thing. But the only problem is that the difference between Eco Styler Gel and Gorilla Snot is that Gorilla Snot will leave yellow flakes in your hair. And I really hate that. But, I mean, my hair still looks cute, but at the same time, it don't look the best. So, yeah. I ain't here to tell you which gel to use, but I'm just saying, that's the gel I use, so. Yep. Anyways, that's it for this video, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And, yeah. Bye, guys. Okay, before I end this video, I forgot to say, comment down below some questions for a Q&A video.
You don't go to clubs now. That's why your money long now. Baby girl, you should come. You should come.